So you did not ask me about the proof of this theorem, Lebesgue theorem. Why do we consider here B lambda in the definition? Of course, it should be A, yes? But if for this A, the value of the function is smaller than lambda, but for any subset of A, B lambda definitely subset of A by definition, it's also smaller than this lambda, okay? So we only can decrease this density, if you will. Now, about the corollaries. About the corollaries, we have this decomposition, but this decomposition works for measurable sets only. And the corollary, I want to give you the following. The first one corollary, if E is measurable, then almost everywhere except the set of zero measure, there exists density phi x, and this density equals 0 or 1. Equals 0 or 1, okay? Almost everywhere on the line. Almost everywhere on the line, there exists density. Why this is true? Just by Lebesgue density theorem. Indeed. What do we have? By Lebesgue density theorem, we have that set E, measurable set. It is some set A union with some neglectable set Z1, such that we have that phi of E, density of set E, restricted to A is 1. It just means that almost any point of E is point of density. Yes, it's just written here. Now, and measure of Z1 is 0, except the set of zero measure. And the same we have for the complement, of course. And we have that complement of E. It is another set B plus union another set Z2, such that we have that the density of the complement restricted to B is 1. So almost any point is point of density for the complement. And we have that measure of Z2 is 0. But now, if we return to this line, that we see that here we have that density of E restricted to B now is 0, since sum of these densities is 1. Yes, if it is 1, it means that density is 0. So outside is 0 everywhere except of the set of 0 measure. Inside, it is 1. Everywhere except of set of zero measure, and definitely measure of Z1 and Z0 is zero. So except this set, this function takes value 0 and 1, okay? Oh, you can ask, what's the importance of measurability? So Lebesgue density theorem, it works for any set. But if, that's all about the corollary, if we have that set A is not measurable, then what do we have? Of course, we have arguments of the same type. We have arguments of the same type. That is, almost everywhere phi of A of X is 1, yes? And phi of A complement of X also is 1, yeah? For the complement, almost everywhere. But the last one, it does not imply that phi of A of X is 0. If this density of at point X for the complement is 1, it does not mean that this is 0, since for non-measurable set, the sum is not 1, it's larger, okay? If it is not measurable, then we have, it may be 0, maybe positive. It may be positive if it's not measured if it's not measurable. Please, your questions about this remark. The second corollary, the one implication with proof, another without proof. And this is interesting characterization of measurability. Interesting characterization of measurability that it is just what I wrote here, but only one line. E is measurable only if almost every point of density of A is a point of dispersion. Almost every point of E, C are points of dispersion of E. Once more, for this implication, it's clear, trivial, yeah? Again, by this representation. So if it is point of dispersion, it means that this, if it is point of EC, then we have that this is 1 plus 0. So if it is 1, then this is almost all points of EC by the theorem of Lebesgue, we have density 1. Therefore, this is 0, okay, for measurable. But inverse implication is not so fast, we will not prove this. But this is by approximation of measurable sets that we considered with you, also without proof. So there exists some set B containing E such that Borel set. B it is G delta set. B it is G delta set such that outer measure of E equals measure of B, and you can play with this Borel set. Since then it will not disturb too much the definition of density, since in density we considered that one. Okay, so this is the hint what to do. Indeed, I can give you some references. Now, that's not all, since I want to say a few words about importance. What's the reason to consider this Lebesgue density theorem? First of all, of course, it's nice result that shows the structure of sets. You see, important understanding that almost all points are points of density. Now, and there are applications. For example, but this is without details. Without details, one definition. We understand what does it mean continuous function. There are so-called approximately, there is uniformly continuous, and there are many other type of continuity, absolutely continuous, but this is approximately continuous. We will say that function f is approximately continuous at some point, and then at any set if you want, at some point x, if we have that for any epsilon, the set, very concrete set, x such that f of x minus f of x0 is smaller than epsilon, some strip, yeah? This difference smaller than epsilon, has density 1, this is definition, has density 1 at point x0. Once more. Approximately continuous means that for any, at point x0, for any epsilon, this very concrete set has density 1 at this given point, at this point x0. And immediately what do we have? Clearly that if function is, this is some generalization of continuity, property of continuity. Since if function is continuous, what does it mean? It means that this is integral, yes, open some set. And of course, then we have that this open set has density 1. It's by Lebesgue theorem. Now, but in general, of course, this can have any kind of for different functions. Simple example that shows that, of course, in general, they are different. If you take Dirichlet function, characteristic function of set of rational. This function is approximately continuous, not everywhere, for any irrational value. It's easy to see, very easy to see, because density is given in terms of outer measure, yes? And outer measure of set of rational is zero. Therefore, these rational points, they cannot disturb the situation, okay? Definitely, we have that. At this point, any point is density. Approximately continuous. And now, so this, there are some results. We don't have time to discuss all them. And this, of course, is given in terms of density. And now, one of these results is rather useful. We will study with you next week or maybe later. It's time to start measurable functions. So now, by this symbol, I will denote so-called measurable, of course, with respect to Lebesgue. measurable functions. There are some measurable functions. Indeed, in the first lecture, we discussed what is this. It means that just this preimage of the type is there is a f of x larger than alpha, smaller than beta. The set of the type is measurable. Indeed, this is the one definition if we have this for any alpha beta. Even it's enough to consider only one inequality. Now look. So this is collection of measurable functions. And this is very important, the theory of integration, the concept. And there are different characterizations of measurable functions that we will study with you, Lusin theorem, some others. And one of these characterizations is given just in terms of this approximate continuity, if and only if it's approximately continuous. If and only f is approximately continuous. I can give you reference to this theorem. If it's interesting for you, we don't consider this in details, but this is a kind of application of Lebesgue density theorem. So, characterization of important class of functions, measurable functions. Now, I suggest to consider with you concrete problems. Also, we can say that this is application of Lebesgue density theorem. So, try to solve these problems. At least one I will give you without this density theorem, and you will see that it's not so. It's difficult indeed. They are rather difficult. But using this density theorem, we will have solution by three in one line. So this I want to give you some problems that I gave in the previous year. So one problem is the following problem: we have set E. Let it will be inside of the interval. E is measurable. E is measurable. And the problem consists of two parts. Suppose that let there exist B smaller than 1 such that we have that measure, Lebesgue measure of E intersected to I is less or equal than B and the length of I for any open I. Open, close, not so important, but in promise usually is given by open. Now, then what do we have to prove? Then the measure of E is zero. The measure of E is zero. The second one is the following. Suppose that, let again, there exists A which is positive such that measure of I is smaller, less or equal, that measure of E intersected to I for any open I. Then we have that measure of E is 1. E, that is, it's almost the same interval in the sense of measure. And the conclusion, if you have this 2, so nothing to prove, it's the last one. Thus, there is no, in principle, there is no set E with these properties, such that there are points A, B, such that we have that A measure I less or equal than measure E intersected to I less or equal than B measure of I for any interval I. Yeah? In principle, there is no. Of course, if we will prove first and second, then we will have that on one hand it is zero, on the other hand this is one. So, of course, it's impossible. Okay? So, but look, once more. Without this concept of density, try to do this. And eventually you will repeat arguments of Lebesgue density theorem. But if you have this density theorem, that nothing to do, yes? Because what by Lebesgue density theorem? By Lebesgue density theorem, what do we have from the first line? From the first line, if we will divide this, yes? By the length of interval I and take the limit, then we will have that the phi x is smaller than b, less or equal than b, yes? For any x, you see? For any x, so, and b is smaller than 1. So it's not point of density, yeah? So we have that measure of E is 0 just by Lebesgue density. Do you see this or not, Lebesgue density theorem? So it is smaller than b, less or equal than b, which is smaller than 1. So it is not point of density. It is not point of density. But collection of all points which are not points of density is neglectable. Measure is 0. Yes? Questions? Is it okay? Now, so this is part A. Part B, absolutely the same. we take that, okay, we can consider the complement. Of course, now the complement with respect to this interval, not with respect to the whole line. And then we will have that again upper density. It's the same as we calculate the lower density and then take, since it's measurable, take the difference, yeah? So we have upper density with respect to EC of X again is smaller than 1. Smaller than, less or equal than 1 minus A, yeah? Yeah, then what do we have? We will have that again the corresponding measure is 0. Corresponding measure is 0. It means that measure of what? Measure of the complement. We have that measure of this complement is 0. So we have that measure of E is 1. So please your questions. Please your questions about this problem. With Lebesgue density theorem, it's simple. It's easy to do. Now, that's not all. Now, about generalizations. So it's interesting to try to generalize this. I mean, first of all, to generalize a concept of density, on the other hand, to generalize Vitali covering theorem. For the first one, what can we say? Of course, we can do this for any other measure. For any other outer measure, of course, with the restriction that we have that outer measure of interval is interval, if it's not measurable, but in general, maybe it's not measurable, yeah? It should be larger than 0, smaller than infinity, otherwise we will have problems with the definition of that stuff, okay? In principle, it can be done, why not? And then we will have upper density, lower density of the set A with respect to measure, outer measure mu star at point X. Okay, why not? I will give you one example now. But before, about the Vitali covering, I can give you some references. Carateadori constructed some counterexamples that even for the plane or in Euclidean space, we will have some problems if we will just try to repeat these Vitali covering arguments. Vitali covering arguments, since the question is what should we take instead of intervals? Of course, in this situation, intervals it is this cuboid, yeah? But then if we will take this cuboid, then we have to exclude the case, it is just what was done by Carateadori, which are very, very slim. If they are very slim, that generally does not work. I mean, these arguments, ideology of Vitali covering. So there are some coverings such that we cannot choose given epsilon finite union of intervals. It's rather surprising, yes? Because for us, it's, as usual, if something works for the line, then it works for the plane and for the Euclidean space. But it's not the case for that one. So there are generalizations of Vitali covering theorem for this case. But in this generalization, they consider it coverings of special type. Coverings of set by rectangles, by cuboids of that type, but not of that type, very roughly speaking, okay? Now look about the generalization of density for other measures. It's also, I want to give you one problem that I gave, by the way, in the final exam 1 year. So this is problem was the following. I will not solve it. So I recommend you do it home yourself. It's not homework, just as a repetition, okay? Now, given it is problem 2 from the previous final. So given Borel measure mu on the line with the condition such that we have that measure of n infinity is finite, of course not Lebesgue, yeah, and positive for any n. Let n for any set E, which is measurable, with respect to this measure, of course, with respect of this measure, mu. Let us define, so this is definition. Let us define lower density at infinity and upper density at infinity in very, very natural way. So what is lower density at infinity of the set E? Of course, it is limit, and here this measure, not outer measure, since all stuff is measurable. Here we have E intersected limit vector to n, of course, intersect to 2i n, and here mu of I n, where for shortness I denote this stuff by I n. Okay? Definition. Now, and we understand what is upper density. It is the same, but now we take upper limit with respect to this n. So there are some values. There are some values. Okay? Again from 0 to 1. Again from 0 to 1. So the problem was the following. Construct a measure mu, construct mu on R, of course, Borel, such that we have that this lower density, set E will be given at infinity is 0, upper density at infinity it is 1, for what is set E? E, it is set of even for set E, which is 2n from 1 to infinity. So, hint, of course, it's enough to put this measure only on the set of natural, to take support with set of natural, then you will do this. Okay, so try to do this. This is useful exercise. So this is simple illustration that, first of all, we can consider some density at infinity, and we can do for other measures. But, of course, it should be well-defined. Now that's enough. And now we are ready to start another subject, if you have no questions. And this another subject, it is 3.5. It's very interesting, in my opinion, generalization of Lebesgue measure. There are some generalizations of Lebesgue measure, two of the most important are Lebesgue-Stieltjes measure that we will consider with you next time, and the Hausdorff measure. And today, the rest of the lecture, we will consider with you Hausdorff measures. Hausdorff measures, there are a lot of them. There is unique Lebesgue measure, and there are a lot of Hausdorff measures, and Hausdorff dimension. And here I use single, but also we will see with you there are different Hausdorff dimensions. First of all, I'd like to recall you, what is the Lebesgue outer measure? Lebesgue outer measure, okay, I will write immediately mu s star delta A. Lebesgue outer measure is given as the infimum of length of intervals ik, yes, where ik union of ik covers a set A, covers set A. And now we will do absolutely the same, but only we have some parameter s. We will put parameter s here. What is s? S here, it is any real number, non-negative. Now, what is delta? Delta, we consider all coverings without loss of generality. Suppose now that ik are open, but again, it will not change situation so much. We can consider covering by any type of intervals, so it's not so important, just for convenience. Now, and what is more? What is delta? We consider coverings only by intervals with small length smaller than delta. So, please, it's not very special stuff. It's absolutely the same as above, yes? But in the Lebesgue measure, we consider infimum of sum of lengths of intervals for all coverings. It is infimum of sum of lengths at degree s, yes? But with this additional restriction smaller than delta. So, let's look, what is this one? This is some function. This is some function, definitely. This is well-defined for any set we can do this. And this function has some nice properties. What are these nice properties? So this is some outer measure. Then we have that mu star s delta A. It is some outer measure. Okay? What does it mean? For empty set, it is zero. It is monotone. Monotonicity immediately trivial, but sigma sub additivity, it's not trivial, but possible to show. Okay, outer measure. Translation invariant, nice property. Of course, if you shift the set, then you can shift the covering, it will be the same, yeah? And it's not all, And such that, it has some good property, but we will lose this property for one important reason. Such that for any bounded set A, we have that this mu S star delta A is finite. It has always finite values, of course, trivially. Since if it is bounded, we can cover by one interval, so this is definitely will be some finite value, yes? So, outer measure, but, and this is very important, but in general, this collection of measurable sets, yeah, delta A, in the sense of Caratteri-Adorei, I don't want to repeat this definition, yeah, may be very small. It may be very poor. Of course, always for any outer measure, we have empty set, we have x, maybe there is something else. But if we have no interval inside of collection of measurable sets, then it's not good outer measure, yes? Then we can't work with Borel sets, so collection is very small. It's very poor. It means that interval in general does not belong to this collection. If interval does not belong to this collection, of course, for more complicated Borel sets, nothing to discuss. Okay, example. Let's consider example. Take S smaller than 1, S from 0 to 1. Take set, any interval I. It is interval AB. Let be closed interval now. I want to show that it's not measurable. How to show that it's not measurable? It's enough to choose set A, such that we have that outer measure, I don't want to write, okay, I will do. Okay, this is delta A, it's not the same, otherwise it will be measurable, definition of Caratteri-Adorei. And here we have delta A intersected to I, and plus outer measure S, and here delta A minus I. So, if we don't have this, at least for one set A, then definitely this I is not measurable. Okay? Definition. So, what can we take for this A? Let A equals A minus epsilon, also interval A plus epsilon, and we take epsilon smaller than delta. We will take epsilon smaller than delta. Let's look, what do we have? What do we have for... let's take 2 epsilon smaller than delta. Okay. Well, 15 epsilon smaller than delta. Okay, so what can we say about this value of outer measure for the interval? So this sum interval of the length 2 epsilon, which is smaller than delta, yeah? In principle, and this is infimum. This is infimum for all coverings. So definitely this infimum less or equal than the value of if you will take covering by one interval. If you'll take covering by one interval, then we will have just this 2 epsilon at degree s. Okay? Is it clear or not? You can take S 1 over 2, 1 over 3 for define S. So once more, this is the length of interval, and this is S, definite. This is the infimum, yes? Now, and what do we have for the S? But now we want to, I want to show that it's strictly less and not equal. So we can estimate this from above without problem, yeah? But here indeed we have to estimate from below. But it's not so important. So now we consider this delta and this intersection. This intersection, it is interval A minus epsilon A. A minus epsilon A, yes? And now, intersection of this and this one, it is A plus epsilon. And now, indeed, this is infimum, yeah? And we have to consider all coverings, all possible coverings. But look, the situation is the following. If we take the covering by one interval, it will be epsilon s. epsilon s, yeah, if you take covering by one integral, okay? But in principle, of course, one can say, why can't we cover, what can we decompose this interval of the length epsilon into some collection of intervals? And then I recommend you to do this. If you, for example, divide in two intervals, then what we will have? We will have two, since there are two intervals now, and here epsilon over 2s. Epsilon over 2s. S is smaller than 1. Let's take s to define this, for example, 1 over 2. Then what we will have? We will have square root of 2 epsilon s, epsilon 1 over 2. But this is epsilon 1 over 2. Of course, this is larger. Of course, this is larger. And we want to get epsilon, some infimum. We want to have as small value as possible. Okay? What I want to say? I want to say the following. In order to have this value as small as possible, we are interested to cover this set by one interval. If we will try to cover by two intervals or by some collection of intervals, then I recommend you to check. I did it just for uniform. We cover by two intervals of the same length, and then we will have something which is larger. Okay? So if we will divide this, for example, we will divide this interval into n parts. If we will divide the intervals into n parts, we will have n parts, n intervals, and every of them has the length epsilon over n 1 over 2. So square root of n epsilon 1 over 2, this is much larger. If we will enlarge the number, of course, this is only for uniform. But for non-uniform, the same arguments, okay? So, once more, we can write that this is epsilon s, since otherwise, if we will cover not by one interval, by some family of intervals, we only will enlarge this value. But we want to have infimum. Therefore, the same arguments, of course, we have for another one. And now we have here 2 epsilon s, and here we have 2 multiplied by epsilon s. Of course, this is larger, and of course, it is not equal, since s is smaller than 1. So, interval is not measurable. It's not good to start this Caratteodori procedure, yeah? Of course, we will have some measure, but this measure will be very poor in the sense of collection of measurable sets, yes? But there is a nice thing, this nice idea is the following. Let us now, so this is for fixed delta. This is for fixed delta. Now let's decrease delta. Move delta to zero. If we will move this delta to zero, then what can we say about these values of delta for any fixed concrete set? Then it will be larger, larger, and larger. Why? Because if we decrease delta, here we consider infimum. Infimum for some collection of sets with this restriction, yes? But if you will decrease delta, it means we will decrease collection of sets. If you will decrease collection of sets, the infimum can be only larger. Okay? Is it clear, yeah? So look, infimum for this set, of course, is smaller than infimum for this set. Yes? So we decrease the collection of sets, infimum is larger. So it will decrease. It will increase. It will increase, and therefore it will be the limit for any concrete A, for any concrete A set A. It will have a limit, and this limit we will denote with u now. It's again m star a. Now, what do we lose now? In this situation, unfortunately, we lose this good property. So even for bounded set, it may be infinity, it's very easy, yeah? So we will have some value from 0 to plus infinity is included. We will lose this finiteness for bounded set. But now there is great advantage that this is also will be outer measure. We have that, I don't want to prove with you details. This is outer measure, Hausdorff as outer measure. What is important? Important that interval minus infinity A is measurable now with respect to this outer measure. Okay? This fact is not so trivial, but nevertheless it can be done. We will not do this with you. It can be done. Also, if you want, I can give you references. We have no time for this stuff. And if interval is measurable, definitely this is sigma algebra. We have that now this collection is rather good, yeah? At least it contains Borel sets. So this is good measure for we have. And definitely this is generalization of Lebesgue measure. It's better to say to Lebesgue measures, since for different S, we will have different measures, Lebesgue measures on the line, on the plane. So please, your questions about this idea of Hausdorff. Idea of Hausdorff. There is, instead of that one, to take in degree S, and then we will have. So this is non-trivial embedding, but it's possible to do. Of course, here for any A. Now, okay. Now it's time to define the Hausdorff measure, Hausdorff S measure. It's clearly what is this. Now we have that MS Hausdorff measure. Of course, it is a restriction of this Hausdorff outer measure on the corresponding collection. On the corresponding collection. So this is Hausdorff measure that is defined on Borel sets. Now I want to give you some examples. Yes, it's time to. Or maybe before examples, what can we say easily? We can say easily that this is also translation invariant. We have that mu s translation invariant. It's trivial, yeah? Invariant. What else? It is metric. Metric measure. It's not difficult, not surprising, since if sets are distant, of course, we can cover them by distant coverings. So this is more or less clearly. And now, what do we have for this measure or for outer measure? It's the same. I will write outer measure since it works for any set not measurable in general. We have MS star for any coefficient k, and here A, it is KS. And here M star A, okay? So there is some this homogeneity, a kind of homogeneity with coefficient S property. It can be done also. It's, indeed, it's not difficult if you look at the definition. And of course, if A is measurable, we can remove this star. And now let's look at examples. Examples. The first example shows that indeed it is generalization of Lebesgue measure. So if S equals 1, what do we have? It is just Lebesgue construction, or maybe Carotet-Dorey reconstruction, to introduce Lebesgue measure. Absolutely the same, absolutely the same. We have that mu 1, it is just M, Lebesgue measure, yes? Clearly. Now, that's not all. If we take that S, it is some number d, which is natural number, that what do we have for this MD measure, Hausdorff measure. Now look, we will cover indeed all our results. We consider almost all for the line, and we will consider with you later the what to do for Euclidean space. For Euclidean space, there are indeed two ways. First of all, we can construct the Lebesgue idea if we replace intervals by these cuboids, or etc., consider semi-ring of corresponding sets. And other way, it's using Fubini theorem. If we have the measure for the line, then we can introduce the measure for the product space. Okay? And now look. So in the first way, if you will take here, for example, 2 or 3 or 4, then what do we have? We just have Lebesgue construction. But we will cover integrals now by balls, for example, or by rectangles. It depends on agreement, you see. And will be just a kind of area if S equal 2 up to coefficient, or volume if we take S equal 3 again up to coefficient. Okay? Do you see this? What is the volume? Volume, it is just the result of the coverings of that by balls taking the limit. Okay? So we'll have just this Lebesgue d-dimensional measure. So we have that MD, it is just CD multiplied by MD, where what is this? MD, it is d-dimensional Lebesgue measure in the space RD, And what is it? Some coefficient. So now about this coefficient. It depends on agreement. Depends on agreement. So here this is given for the line. Yeah, we cover the set on the line by the intervals. Yeah. So the question: if now we have a set in the space RD, and we considered covering by set A by some model sets. The question, what are model sets? Yeah? What is the most natural covering? Maybe somebody prefer to cover by rectangles, by cuboids. Then, of course, we don't need this coefficient. But as usual, the people covers by balls for some reason. So if we cover this now, the set A by balls, so it is some ball with some radius, yeah? Some ball xn rn, it covers A, so once more, B it is open ball of radius rn. Then what do we have? What do we have? According to this definition, so what we will take? We take, this is a kind of lens, yeah, it's a kind of lens. So we will have now diameters, yeah? We have here 2rn in degree s, according to this definition. So the length of interval, instead of length of interval, we have to take diameter of this set, okay? So now what do we want? We want to have generalization of d-dimensional measure. So if we take usual ball, if you take usual ball, then it must be the same as measure of the ball must be the same as that one. So this is the hint, what is this CD? So for this CD, it is the volume FD minus one, when VD, it is the volume of unit ball in the space RD. There are some formulas for unit ball in any d-dimensional space in terms of gamma function of Euler. Not very difficult to get it. Construct by integrate, use some polar coordinates, spherical coordinates, you will get it. But we must be careful since here it is 2rn, so maybe we have to include also that one. So once more, what I want to say. I want to say that if we take just the ball, one ball, for example, of radius 1, then the result, it will be covering by this ball, so it is 2. Maybe we have to include here 2 minus s by this definition, by d. D minus this by this definition. Okay, so this is generalization. Now let's look at another example. Another example is very important in theory, in potential theory. There is a big field. Indeed, here, this is the next step to generalize this idea. What do we do? We consider some function, just we consider function ts instead of function t. But we can take any function indeed, with more or less good properties instead of t. So we can take function phi, now it's not density, but for many people denote this by phi, I also will use this. And this function is very important in potential theory. In potential theory, the graph of this function, if we will use calculus, will be something like this. Of course, here we will consider with u t from 0 to 1 in order to be well defined. Yeah? Now look, so this is the graph of the function. This is the graph of the function, so this is t. This is phi of t, so this is, if you look from that side, it will be flat. And now look, and we can do absolutely the same. But now we will consider, we can consider mu phi. What is this mu phi? This mu phi, it is Hausdorff measure that corresponds to that function. So at the beginning, we take mu phi star delta A, and this will be infimum of the sum of phi of Rn, Rn, okay? And we consider all coverings of Bn of the set A. You see, we can do this, yeah? With the Rn, Rn smaller than delta. So instead of this, we can take function phi. Of course, now this measure will be much larger than all these Hausdorff measures. Clearly, yes? Because look, even at the beginning, for example, s, we consider s from 0 to 1. What does it mean? It means that we considered function of that type. Yeah? But now for any rn, instead of these values, we will take this value. Of course, this is much larger for that function if radius is small enough. Okay? So now this measure will fill small sets. Small sets in the following way. So we have some small sets, exceptional, very important, the theory of potential. And the measure, Lebesgue measure, and Hausdorff measure of the set is 0. But this logarithmic measure is not 0, okay? So then after this, we will have function using the same way. And this is so-called logarithmic measure. This logarithmic measure is not 0 for these small exceptional sets. And what is more, there are important, crucial results in potential theory. One of them, there is huge theory, by the way, at the moment. And the first results were obtained 100 years ago. Indeed, the first results in potential theory were obtained by Gauss and before. But I mean the first result of geometric description, in geometric function theory, the Lindenberg result, he did it in 1918, almost 100 years ago. And he proved the following, that, okay, what Lindenberg proved? He proved that if this logarithmic measure of compact set K is 0, then we have that capacity is 0. We don't have time to discuss what is capacity, but this is exceptional set in potential theory in this sense. Exceptional, for example, harmonic function. If function is harmonic everywhere, removable set in the sense that if function is harmonic everywhere except the set of capacity 0, then we can extend it by continuity. It will be harmonic everywhere, okay, in domain. So it is a kind of removable singularity for harmonic functions. In potential theory, it's a very important concept. Okay, and also Erdős and Gillis, they later proved that in 37, it seems to me, that if we have that mu phi of k is positive, if we have that capacity of k is positive, then we will have that this function q is infinity. So it's a kind of geometric description in terms of this special measure. But unfortunately, as was proved later, there is no function f such that it will characterize this fact that capacity is 0 if and only if mf of k is 0. So there are some results. Also, they were obtained 70 years ago that says that, in principle, unfortunately, we can't characterize the fact that set is exceptional in potential theory in terms of some Hausdorff measure. Now, the next one, okay, so we will continue next week, but I want to suggest you a kind of project, if it's interesting for you. For example, if you don't understand what to do, in your master thesis or something. Look, it's possible to show, some of you took the book of Akstovbe, In this Akstovbe you can find the proof. We considered with you somehow Liouville numbers, Liouville numbers, they are some irrational numbers that can be approximated by rationals very fastly, I don't want predefinition. What do we know about these Liouville numbers? We don't do this, but it is written in this Akstovbe book and in some other sources. For any S, from positive S, we have that MS measure, not only Lebesgue measure. Not only Lebesgue measure of Liouville numbers is 0, but any Hausdorff measure of that type is 0, okay? But it's interesting to, it's more related to Hausdorff dimension that we'll discuss with you next time. But it's interesting to find function F, which will just be responsible for these Liouville numbers, okay? That is to find some function this function, it seems to me, it's very large. Maybe, of course, there are a lot of, here there is this logarithmic function phi of t. Here there is function ts for any s which is positive here. And between them, of course, there are a lot of other functions. It's interesting to find function which is responsible, in a sense, for these Liouville numbers, in the sense that the corresponding measure mf of this set will be positive and finite. Maybe it was done, it's necessary to make to do a search in the internet, okay? But then, if you will find this function, that it will be possible to introduce some special dimension, not Hausdorff dimension, but special dimension, we will discuss with you next time, which is also responsible for these Liouville numbers. So, in my opinion, this is a rather interesting problem. Maybe some people did it, I don't know, I am not expert for these Liouville numbers, but if not, you can try. Okay, so no midterm this week, next week. Okay, nice. See you.